Picking is binary. It's an even thing, down and up, right? So when you throw in a triplet, you've got a three-note group. Well, it's going to flip your picking around. Now, I'm going to demonstrate this. If I'm playing over a groove, one, let two, let three, let four, let one, let two, let three, let down, up, right there. If I decide to play the eighth note triplets, I'm going to go one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet. So that means that the first one's down, up, down. The next one's up, down, up. Now, you might say, well, couldn't I go down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down? You could at a slower tempo, and that's a valid way to play the triplets. But at these faster tempos, it wouldn't even be practical. So you're going to go. So what I just played was just a series of eighth note triplets. One triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, right on up. All right, that sounds good. It's driving. If I decide to play, and intersperse some of the eighth notes, it's going to flip me around. I'll demonstrate. If I decide to play a line that goes one triplet, two, let three, four, da 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 da, my picking's going to be down, up, down, and then I play an upstroke that's on a number. The triplet has turned me around. Then I might play another downstroke, depending upon where I'm playing, to accent that. You see, we're not adhering to these strict rules. It's all about feel. Down, up, down, up. Those were the quarter note triplets. Da, 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 da. Each of those notes are getting two-thirds of a beat. I want to end this segment by going back to rhythm guitar. Now, it's kind of, you wouldn't do it over this jazz thing so much. If we were playing a blues shuffle that was driving more, you might insert some of those eighth note triplets in your rhythm work. So your picking would be down, up, down, up. That's it. Putting an X. So da, 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 da. Da 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 da. You put that X in there. Down, up, down, up is a dead, then down strokes your kick. Da da da. Right there, I'm going da da. To stay in the pocket, I'm playing some X's. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. You see it? Those X's are for my benefit to stay in the pocket. Cross rhythms, we talked about those a couple series ago, where you keep a figure going that isn't symmetrical in the bar. Now, I've just given you a little overview on this swing issue. Make sure you listen not just to the strict rhythmic aspect of great soloists and jazz players, but there's a lot more than just looking at it from a counting standpoint. The issue of playing either right in the middle of the beat or a little ahead, a little behind, and just the elastic flow is very important. It's beyond the scope of this lesson. It's really an exercise in ear training. So make sure that you listen, not just to the jazz guys, to everything you listen to you should learn from. But especially on this jazz stuff, the triplet feel, there's interpretation involved here. But don't neglect. I'm going to close this by saying don't neglect your picking. Address what's going on and look at the options. You either have down or up. You either alternate or you use the same stroke in a row, or you don't play, and you get your check and just wait for the guy to bring the cash.